Hi, and welcome to Bree Healthy. It's the most wonderful time of the year, as they say. I personally prefer when it's a little bit warmer, but I'm always down for some holiday cheer. The holiday season reminds me of comfort, warmth, the joy of giving, and also spending time with people I love. This time of year is extra special for me, though, because my birthday falls right in the middle of it. I celebrated my 26th birthday on December 2nd and enjoyed it with family and friends. I ate all the food and felt no shame about it. I also celebrated by hosting a birthday brunch party at my house with some close friends, complete with a mimosa bar and tea sandwiches, which was so much fun. My birthday is the one day of the year when I allow myself to fully relax and simply enjoy every moment of my special day. And I'm so grateful to see all of the beautiful things that this new year brings. Speaking of the new year, I can't believe that 2018 is coming to a close. I feel like this year totally flew by, but it was honestly my favorite year yet. So many amazing things happened this year, like when I was featured on the Today Show on the Joy Fit Club segment. I had the opportunity to meet the beautiful Joy Bauer, Jenna Bush Hager, and the legendary Kathy Lee Gifford and talk about my weight loss success. Kathy Lee recently announced that she's leaving the Today Show, so I'm so grateful to have met her when I did. Being on the show was honestly one of the best moments of my life, and it still feels so surreal that it even happened. Another one of my favorite moments of this year was getting married to the love of my life in my favorite place in Rhode Island. We eloped and it was such a perfect day. VJ and I then had our reception over the summer in the town I grew up in Connecticut. I'm so grateful for the way we celebrated, and I'm so proud to have added the Alexander last name to my own name. One of my favorite achievements of this year was becoming an Athleta brand ambassador. I'm so proud to represent this incredible company, and I'm so grateful to have started my Women-Inspired event series in their space. Being able to showcase powerful, inspiring women in front of an audience of lots of awesome women has been such a dream come true for me. For real, this year has been amazing. I plan to post even more of my favorite moments on my Instagram, so stay posted on there for even more of my faves. This show is packed with holiday fun and so much cheer. We'll be baking up some scrumptious holiday cookies, and it's a recipe that so many of you at home have been asking for. Then one of my favorite fitness friends will be joining us and demonstrating a yoga flow that helps with digestion, which is perfect for before any holiday meal. But first, I want to showcase some awesome small businesses that I truly believe in and that would make for great holiday gifts. It's time for Bree's Support Small Business Gift Guide. You might be wondering what I'm drinking in this pint glass. I'll give you two hints. It's not alcoholic and it's hot. I'm drinking some beef and chicken bone broth from Brothmasters. Bone broth is said to provide so many health benefits, including the aid of gut health, supporting the immune system, it contains anti-inflammatory properties, and it's rich in calcium, collagen, and so many vitamins and minerals. And these are just some of the health benefits. And in honor of the holiday season, I want to help spread a little extra cheer. One lucky viewer will win 6 packs of bone broth from Brothmasters to try on their own. To enter the giveaway, all you have to do is make sure you're subscribed to my YouTube channel and leave a comment saying Brothmasters giveaway in the comments on this YouTube video. I'll be responding to the winner in the comments, so make sure your notifications are turned on. Brothmasters is a family-owned business, and I was actually able to meet the whole family, who are such kind and generous people. They truly run their business from the heart, and I believe that's what the holiday season is really all about. Now, I have a few more gifts to show you over at the table. Follow me. First up, we have the most perfect stocking stuffer. Rawmantic Chocolate is an amazing brand that handcrafts their organic chocolate right here in New York. The founder, Kasha, is a fellow girl boss, and she's one of the sweetest people I've ever met, pun intended. Their products are sweetened with natural ingredients, including honey, dates, and pure maple syrup, and they're free of dairy, lactose, gluten, preservatives, artificial colors and flavors, and GMOs. Their packaging is compostable, and they make so many delicious products, from bars to truffles, granola, and protein bars like their new fitness bar. Another one of their newer products are the amazing superfood macarons, which would make perfect gifts for your boss, your special someone, or any chocolate lover in your life. Over here, we have another awesome product, and this time it's an all-in-one natural skincare and hair care cream. She Plants Love is a functional body butter that's high in antioxidants, plant nutrients, and anti-inflammatory properties. It's handcrafted in Rhode Island by the founder, Far, another girl boss who I had the pleasure of meeting earlier this year. I use the butter on my hands as a moisturizer, which is such a lifesaver during this time of year, but it can also be used as a scalp conditioner, makeup remover, hairstyling cream, and more. This gift is perfect for anyone who uses any skincare or hair care product, which is pretty much everyone, especially those who prefer natural, good-for-you products. Last but certainly not least, we have one of my favorite brands, the Bar Shack. This brand allows you to completely customize and design your own protein bars. You choose every ingredient on their website, even down to the consistency you desire, and they're made by hand in Florida. Look at these Brie Healthy bars, so cool! There are a multitude of organic and all-natural ingredients to choose from, oops, with many superfoods and types of protein powders offered. As you can see here, I recently designed two different kinds of my very own protein bars, the Brie Healthy Bar and my Women-Inspired Bar. I'm absolutely in love with this brand, and it's seriously so much fun to order them. You can gift these to your loved ones by either designing a box of bars and picking their favorite ingredients, or you can buy them a gift card for them to create their own. This is such a fun gift for anyone who exercises, as protein is essential after any workout. Even people who don't like to exercise will love these as snacks. When you order, don't forget to use my promo code BRIE5FREE to get bonus pre-designed macaw protein bars, also made by the Bar Shack. It's always a great idea to support local businesses, especially during this time of year. I've provided a link to each of these businesses in the caption of this video, so go ahead and get your holiday shopping done. Or just go ahead and treat yourself. Coming up, I'm going to show you how to make some super easy and super delicious peanut butter cookies. Don't go away. Welcome back to Brie Healthy. When I think of holiday sweets, one type of treat specifically sticks out in my mind, cookies. I feel like holiday cookies are such a feel-good treat. They remind me of warmth, comfort, and quality time spent with family and friends. I'm also reminded about how delicious my house smells when I bake my own. Now, I'm all about treating ourselves mindfully, but it can be very helpful to have a healthier cookie option available at your holiday gatherings. That's why it's time for Brie Makes It Better Holiday Cookies Edition! I asked you, my beautiful viewers, on Instagram what flavor of holiday cookie you'd like to see me healthify. So many of you requested one particular flavor, so many that I had to pick it. Today, we'll be making quick and easy peanut butter cookies. They're so tasty and require very few ingredients. They're all natural, gluten-free, and perfect for the holidays. Let's get to baking. All right, so as you can see, there's only a few ingredients, and the first one we're gonna add is peanut butter. So I have a half a cup of natural peanut butter here. I'm gonna add it right to the bowl. Now you wanna make sure that you choose a peanut butter that has no hydrogenated oils in it. So make sure to read the labels because it's gonna be so important to avoid trans fat. Whenever you see the word hydrogenated, just know it means that there's trans fat in there, even if it says 0 grams. So put that in there, sticking to the spoon, but that's okay. Now we're gonna add one egg. Go ahead and crack that in there. Now I have 1/4 cup of oat flour, which is just ground oats. Go ahead and add that in there. And 1/2 cup of date sugar. So date sugar is basically just dehydrated and ground up dates. So it's not refined sugar. Ooh, cause a little smoky effect. Feels like it's Halloween. Now I have 1 teaspoon of pure vanilla extract. Pour that right in there. And just a little bit of pink Himalayan salt. Now we're gonna go ahead and whisk it all up using a hand mixer on the low speed. All I love my hand mixer. I always have so much fun with it. Just be mindful that some of this date sugar might just be super powdery and come flowing up at you, but totally okay. Now make sure you mix everything super well. All right, so once it is all mixed together, now it's time to form them into cookie shapes. So put this over here and make sure you have a baking sheet lined with parchment paper. And I sprayed mine with some nonstick olive oil spray. So now we're gonna form these into dough balls. Now you're gonna wanna make about 12. So just kind of ration it out. It should be about an inch in diameter each. So just take some, you're gonna roll it in your palms. It's gonna be so much fun, you know, all that holiday cheer. So squish it, roll it, and put it right on the baking sheet. And then when you have them all rolled, all on the baking sheet, now it's time to form them into cookie shapes. So this part is super fun. You're gonna use your hands, so my rings are off, and your hands are gonna get messy, so you might wanna keep a paper towel around. Basically, you're just gonna go ahead and press down, flatten the cookie a little bit until it's like that, and you'll go ahead and do this to all of them. So as you can see, some of the edges might get a little frayed, but all you have to do is just retouch them. Just push the edges back in, shape them the way you want. There you go. Now continue with all the rest of the cookies until they all look like cookies. All right, last one. All right, so they're all done. Now we're gonna do one last step before we pop them in the oven. We're gonna go ahead and use a fork to just score them a little bit. Now we put these cross hatches in because peanut butter cookie dough tends to be denser than regular cookie dough, and so it helps it to bake more evenly. I am so excited to pop these in the oven because it's going to smell so nice in here. All right, now I'm ready to go pop them into the oven, which has been preheated at 350 degrees. All right, let's see how these turn out. I can't wait to taste them. Oh my God, you guys. Here they are, all set and ready, and they smell exactly how I expected them to. Amazing. All right, so now we're gonna use a spatula to transfer them to a cooling rack. It'll help them to cool down evenly and not be too soggy on the bottom. So once you get them all on here, then just let them cool for a few minutes. Doesn't have to be too long. We baked them for 10 minutes, by the way. So fast, so easy, and these are so delicious. Can't wait to give them a final taste test. All right. Now just let them cool there for a few minutes, but I kind of want to try one now. Let's see. Okay, they're very hot. I just need to take a taste. They are so good, you guys. Oh my gosh. Who would have thought a simple peanut butter cookie could be so delicious? They have just the right amount of sweetness. They are so simple, so delicious, and each cookie is less than 100 calories. You can find the full recipe on BreeHealthy.com and go ahead and make these this holiday season or really at any time of year. Don't go away because when we come back, I'll be chatting with one of my favorite female fitness friends. Welcome back to Bree Healthy. When I moved to New York City and discovered the fitness community out here, it completely changed my life. I met so many amazing, kind, and like-minded people that shared the same interests as me. Today, we have a very special guest on the show, and she's one of the first members of the New York City fitness community that I ever met. She's one of the kindest women I've ever met, and she's one of the strongest and most dedicated individuals I've ever known. Please give a warm welcome to Gail Barranda Rivas.
Hey.
Thank you so much for coming by.
Thank you so much for having me.
Of course. So Gail and I met a few years ago, and I took her surf set class, which is basically a surfing-inspired workout. So fun. It's like an instable surfboard. Amazing workout, and she's an amazing instructor.
Thank you so much.
So glad to have you here. And then we kept running into each other all the time, and it was as if we were just meant to be in each other's lives.
And in a city like New York with like a gajillion people, how crazy is that, right?
Exactly. It's such a small world sometimes. But so I have a couple questions to ask you.
Okay.
So you are an incredible fitness instructor and an amazing person, of course. So what inspired your love for health and fitness?
So sports and dancing have always been a big part of my life. I grew up playing sports. I grew up dancing. And I always thought that I'd have to at some point get a real corporate job. So that's what I did. But the fitness thing was always a calling. So part-time, I would teach classes, and that wound up being what I loved the most about my day, my students, the energy of the people, and how good I felt doing it. And so inevitably, I said, I need to make a career change, and that's what I did. And now fitness is my full-time gig, and I'm extremely happy about it.
That is incredible. And the fact that you're able to help change people's lives every day, make them a healthier person, that's one of the most beautiful things in the world. So what are some of the classes that you teach?
So first and foremost, I'm a group fitness instructor, and I'm also a certified functional strength coach. I have a bunch of other different, I teach a bunch of other different formats, TRX, DVRT, of course, Surfset, NYC, a bunch of different things because I love learning and I love bringing what I know, my passion, to other people. It's what I love to do. I like to share. If I love it, I know other people will love it as well. So I teach a lot of different things.
Absolutely. And when you do a big mix of different types of workouts, that's also really beneficial for your own body and your own strength, right?
Definitely, because everything is connected. Everything is connected. So you can teach a strength training class, but if you add some elements of like Pilates or yoga, there are ways where they are relatable, mm-hmm. definitely. And it can translate to different people in different ways, and they'll still get it. And it's beautiful when you do see, when people do see the connection and they can apply it to the different formats that they take and the ones that I teach.
Yes, definitely. I love finding those different little elements in all the different classes I take, and I love doing a variety also. So that's so awesome that you teach all those different classes. But since you teach all those, which is your favorite form of fitness?
Oh my gosh, that's so hard. That's like saying, what's your favorite? Who's your favorite child? I love it all because just like you said, it's great to take different things. You don't want to get bored and stuck in a rut taking the one thing. So when I want something like strength and cardio, I'll do surf set, or I will do some kettlebells, some TRX, some ultimate sandbag. And I've started trying this Muay Thai fitness, Muay Thai kickboxing fitness place called Hit House, which I actually love, and that's been great. And when I want the mind-body, when I want to just kind of find zen, I go to Pilates and yoga.
That's awesome. It's like something different for every single mood.
Exactly.
And out here, we are so like blessed to be able to have access to all different types of classes all
exactly.
the time.
Exactly. So why not take advantage of it?
Definitely. So were you always a yogi, or was that something that you kind of got into later on?
It was definitely something I got into later on. Like a lot of people, I think we get intimidated by what yoga is, and especially what you see on social media. It can be very intimidating. It's like, do I have to look like that? Do I have to be so flexible and bendy? And you don't have to be. If you have a body, you can do yoga. If you breathe, you can do yoga. You just need to be open-minded. I think that's the big thing.
Right.
You just need to be open-minded about it. So I discovered it a little bit later. And at first, I wasn't in love with it. And like I tell people who take yoga classes and they say, well, it's not for me. I said, well, hold on. You took one class, but maybe give another shot, because there's different kinds of yoga, and maybe the kind of yoga they took was not something that resonated with them, because that happened to me. I just wasn't into the, say, certain style. And then when I found a place, that was literally, that became my second home. And it changes your life, because that's your safe space. That's
right.
Your safe space. That's where you go when you just need a place to kind of check out, put the blinders on, and just find yourself.
Definitely. When I first started yoga, I tried it years ago, and I was like, everybody says this is supposed to be relaxing. Like, no, it is not relaxing. And then eventually, I guess like later on, I tried it more, maybe when I was a little bit stronger, and I just felt so differently about it. I was like, yes, this is relaxing, because it's not physically relaxing per se. Sometimes it could be,
right.
But my mind and my body, like the connection was there, and my mind was clear, and it was just this incredible thing. And now yoga has really changed my life. I feel like I have a better relationship with my body, better self-image, and I feel like I'm more in tune mind and body. So I'm wondering, is that kind of the same for you? Like, have you had a similar transition once you discovered it?
Definitely. I've learned to appreciate my body. When you take yoga, you have to be in the moment. You have to go there with the presence of mind where you say, okay, I'm not here to do this pose perfectly. I'm here to leave this place feeling a little bit more empowered by what my body can do today. Not tomorrow, not yesterday, today. And if you can go with that, there are no expectations. So you take in what you take in. You are present. And I do love that, because I can go in having the worst day in the world, and then I can leave if I have that no expectation other than I'm just going to take this class and find myself. I can leave feeling so exhilarated, just like you said, in mind and in body. Okay, I can take on the rest of the day, whatever it throws at me.
Right. That's like one thing. They say there's nothing for you to be doing right now. You know, like, you don't have anywhere else to be. This is all, like, nothing else matters. Just be in this moment. And that's one of the most beautiful things. And I feel like the mental and physical aspect is something that a lot of other forms of fitness kind of neglect sometimes. Although there are some that do bring it in. But I feel like that's the most, the biggest form of fitness that can really connect you with your body.
I agree. It can be tough. Other forms of fitness, there's a lot of competition. What's this person doing? I gotta go with that person. I gotta do as many burpees as that person. Whatever it is. And for yoga, you literally do have to have those blinders. And you can, you know, because you will. You'll look at the person and say, oh, well, look at that person. That person, I want to put my head or my hand, you know, my leg around the head. And then you have to say, wait, stop. You take a minute. And do you. And the moment you find that breath and you just kind of maybe close your eyes for 2 seconds to say, okay, no, I'm here for me, my mind, my body, then you find that connection within yourself, and then you don't compare yourself with anyone anymore. And we need that. We all need that, right? Because the
Definitely.
Moment, especially us women, the moment we look in the mirror, right, what happens? Judge. And we really need to stop doing that.
Yes, especially in this day and age with Instagram culture, it's so important for us to take a step back and realize I am worthy, I am perfect the way I am.
That's right.
And you don't need to compare yourself to anyone else, because who could be better than you?
That's right, exactly.
So in addition to all of those mind and body benefits, I've also heard that yoga can help with digestion. Is this true?
Yes, definitely. Part of the things I love about yoga is it not only is detoxing for all the negative things that are going on in your brain, but it's also a nice detox for the body. Certain poses, certain expressions kind of help wring out the insides. They help things flow in their natural way, because face it, a lot of us are sitting culture, right? This is us all day long, and we shrink. And sometimes we just need a little bit of movement to help the body find its natural path. And, you know, when you feel like you're bloated or you just overindulge in this holiday season, we will all do that. Even a few couple of small flow, short yoga flow, can help you release all that bloating, that tightness in the stomach, and just that overall uncomfortableness.
That is so incredible that yoga is able to do that. And I would love to see it firsthand. Will you stick around and show us some of the moves?
Of course, I'd love to.
Awesome, so exciting. But before we do that, I have one question.
What?
You teach at Athleta, right? You teach your classes over there on Monday nights, correct?
Correct. I have a functional mat class at Athleta NYC in the Flatiron District of New York City.
That's awesome. And since we both love Athleta, we want to keep spreading the holiday cheer to you at home. Thanks to our beautiful friends at Athleta, one lucky viewer will win a $50 Athleta shop card. The entry rules are simple. The first step is to make sure that you're following both of us on Instagram. And there are links to our Instagram pages in the caption of this video to make it easy for you. Then leave a comment on this video on YouTube with your Instagram username and your favorite yoga pose or workout move. It's so easy to enter, so don't delay. Stick around because when we come back, Gail will be showing us a yoga flow to help us to better digest all of our holiday meals. Don't go away. Welcome back to Bree Healthy. The abundance of food during the holiday season is so real, and it can often overload our digestive system, leaving us feeling not so great afterward. Thankfully, I have my girl Gail Barranda Rivas here with me, and she's going to show us some yoga poses that can help with digestion. All right, Gail, let's get started.
Thanks, Bree. So these are poses that everyone can do. You don't need a big space at all. Everything we're doing is the size of this mat, so you can do it anywhere in your home, maybe in your office if you have a little space. And it will be great to just kind of wring out anything that needs to be wrung out, wring out the insides, keep you feeling less bloated, get you a little bit more energized for the rest of your day. So we're going to start off on our back. And we're going to lie down. And then we're going to bring the knees up to the chest. And you can rock side to side. This is actually called a wind relieving pose. You can take that as much as however you want to take that.
Good.
And then we can stop at center. And then from here, you're going to bring the arms out to the sides. And then you're going to take your knees and you're going to bring it over to the right side. You can take the left hand, place it on the top part of your thigh. Inhale, find a little bit more length of the spine. As you exhale, melt everything down. Try and keep the shoulder blades down. Soften the jaw, soften the throat. Get rid of any kind of tension, anything that we don't need in the body, in our mind. Get rid of it, let it go. It doesn't belong here. And then from here, let's bring the legs back through center. Let's do the same thing on the other side. So let's bring the knees over to the left side. And then just check in on the body, mental check in on the body, see if the shoulder pops up. Use your breath, inhale, exhale, melt the shoulder down. Again, you can take that hand, you can gently bring the leg down. Try not to yank anything down. We don't want to yank or force anything. We want it to be natural, using the breath to help you. In this position, it's also nice to kind of breathe in through the tight spots of the body. So for a lot of us, it's the hips, right? How many of us sit on that derriere all day long, right? Definitely. So breathe in through the hips, underneath the armpits, melt the shoulder, soften the jaw, relax the throat. And then let's take everything back through center. And then from here, let's bring the feet down. So I like to always include a little heart opener because a lot of people, again, are always hunched over a computer. And especially in this day and age, we need a little bit more heart opening. So let's bring the hands down. Walk your feet back just a little bit. Maybe the fingertips are touching the heels. If they don't, that's okay. From here, you're going to press into your feet. You're going to inhale. As you exhale, slowly roll the hips up. And then press into your feet, plant the palms and the shoulders down, and then push into your feet to open up the chest. For a lot of people, heart openers can be vulnerable, right? Because we're always so closed in. So just use this opportunity, take it like it is, maybe shut the eyes, feel that stretch in the hip flexors, feel that stretch in your pecs, breathe. It's a nice way to bring blood back to the heart, especially when we eat, we compress everything. And then from here, melt the spine back down. You can kind of rock the hips a little bit. Find that neutral spine. And then let's hug the knees into the chest. And again, you can rock side to side. And then from here, you're going to bring your, you're going to inhale. As you exhale, lift the head and shoulders off the mat. Slide the hands down the front of your chin. And you're going to slowly roll yourself up to a sitting position. Good. From here, you're going to cross the ankles, and this is going to be one of my favorite twists. It's a seated spinal twist. So you can do this with the cross at the ankles. You can also do this sitting at your desk. It takes like 2 seconds, and it's a nice way to kind of just, whew, you know, digest everything, especially after a heavy meal. Yeah.
And during the workday.
And during a workday, exactly.
Might need it.
Sometimes I'll need that little break.
Okay? Exactly.
A little bit more sensation. You lengthen the legs in front of you. And then you want to find the sits bones. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, reach underneath the booty. Just do it. Trust me. Okay. So reach underneath the booty. You'll feel that hard flesh. You want to lift the flesh out of the way and find the hard bones. That's what's going to sit you up nice and tall so that we're not slouched over. Okay. Once you find those hard bones, you're going to bring the right knee in towards the chest. Keep sitting up tall. Flex the left foot. You're going to take your right foot, place it on the outside of that left foot. Good. From here, you're going to take that right hand, place it behind you. So right underneath that right butt cheek. You're going to inhale, grow tall through the crown of the head. As you exhale, take that left hand, find the outside of the leg, inhale, lift, exhale, twist. So you control how deep you want this twist to be. Make sure you find the length, so you find that space in the spine, and then as you exhale, every time you exhale, maybe see if you can deepen the twist a little bit more. Make it feel good. You're literally wringing out the insides of all the bad stuff that we don't need. Good. And then gently counter twist it the other way. So just a little slight twist the other way. Let's do the same thing on the other side. So you're going to lengthen the legs, maybe find the sits bones again if you need to. Bring that left knee up towards the chest, sit up nice and tall. Good. Bring that left foot on the outside of the right leg. Take that left hand behind you, right behind the left butt cheek. Inhale, broaden the chest. Exhale, take that heel into the outside of the left thigh and find your twist.
Feels good.
Sure does.
Maybe
find a focal point towards the back of the room. So maybe look over your shoulder. Maybe find a focal point to the back of the room and look at that focal point. Make sure you're breathing. Every time you inhale, think about lifting taller through the crown of the head. And then every time you exhale, see if you can really deepen that twist. Just make sure you're breathing, guys. That's one of the most important things and a lot of things that people forget.
Breathing it's easy to forget.
Helps. Good. And then let's counter twist it, little counter twist. Good. And then from here, we're going to go on to all fours. So your palms are going to be underneath the shoulders. The knees are going to be underneath the hips. You're going to open up your hands, your fingertips. And then from here, little cat-cow. So you're going to inhale, shift the gaze up, stick the booty up. And then as you exhale, press your belly button into your spine as you tuck the chin to the chest. Inhale and exhale. How good does this feel?
Amazing. This is one of my favorites. With my hair and my face.
Yeah, always, always. But that's one of the good parts of it. You let everything go, literally. The hairs in the face, maybe the clothes flap around. It's okay. Yeah, so you're engaging the abs, you're massaging the stomach. Good. And then find neutral. And then from here, let's take a wide child's pose. So you're going to open up the knees, big toes to touch, and sit that booty back on the heels. Reach the hands forward. You just take a couple of breaths. Let's take one more breath here. And then slowly roll up. And there you go. I hope you guys enjoyed that.
Yes. Thank you so much, Gail, for showing me all these moves. So exciting. I love that yoga really has the power to help our digestive system. That's one of the craziest things.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's amazing. And our well-being. I don't know if you see the flushed looks of our faces, but also the big grins.
Definitely. That felt amazing. It was nice and gentle, perfect for any level of fitness
at all.
So go ahead and try these moves at home, whether it's, would you say it's better before you have a big meal or after you have a big meal?
It's good if you do it before a big meal, because I think that also restricts you from eating too much, right? But after a meal, I would suggest just waiting a little bit because the food's still trying to settle, okay?
Definitely. Thank you so much for coming and
Thank
joining us.
Thank you so
us,
much for having me.
Showing us these amazing moves. So
Thanks
grateful.
For joining us, guys.
Yes. I hope that you guys all have a beautiful, amazing holiday. Thank you so much for tuning in today. And I hope that you have an amazing new year. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for even more exciting content.